Welcome to the Isabelle's Heart Show. And judging by my fabulous outfits, most people know I am a total fashion queen. And if you are also a fashion queen, make sure to check out my song Fashionista Baby on YouTube. But if you don't like fashion, that's totally okay, because everyone has their own opinion, and everyone's opinion matters. But even if you don't like fashion, you may still enjoy this craft. So, today I am going to be combining fashion and creativity. Boom. So you guys can walk in style, but not any style, your style. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make super cool rainbow DIY shoes. And the best part about this craft is you can do it at home, right now. So let's get started.
Okay guys, so before we get started, I just want you guys to have a somewhat idea of what this should look like when you're finished. So I have two lovely examples. So this first one is the same brand of shoe that I'm going to be doing today, but basically there's a lot of stuff around it. It's rainbow and it has some hearts on it. It says in style, dance, and then it has I for Isabelle, and then it has bell on it, and basically some cool and crazy designs. And then the other one, I am really happy with the top of this shoe because I was going for a rainbow and I didn't know that the colors would like bleed together that well. So definitely try this out when you're doing it. And then these. One of my favorite parts about this one is work hard, play hard. And then I just put some stars and then some squiggly lines and sort of just wanted the colors to all bleed together. And then for this one is like, pow. There is basically a lot of colors here, all rainbow colors, because I love the rainbow. And then I really love this. All I did was just do circles next to each other, all in the basically rainbow colors, and I just put some rubbing alcohol on it, and it bled like that, and it's really cool. So, what you will need for this great craft is, first of all, a parent supervision, because things can get messy, and parents always help, so yeah. And then you're going to need some rubbing alcohol. Whenever I do this craft, I use the 70% rubbing alcohol version, so yeah, you can basically get this anywhere at your local grocery store or any place like that, so yeah. And just letting you guys know, you will not need a full bottle, so don't go out somewhere and buy a full bottle if you're like doing this. You can just use like a half a bottle and that will probably be more than enough. So yeah, then you're going to need a cup so you can put your rubbing alcohol inside. And then I am using a turkey baster so I can safely get all of my rubbing alcohol over the table to my shoe. And if there is anything else that you guys have used before that you think will work, totally fine. Then these are totally optional, but I have some heart stickers. I have 8 heart stickers, and I really love this, and I'm really excited to try this out. It's just this big teal sticker with a roller skater on it, and it says, "This is how I roll. This is how I roll." And then I'm going to be using some Sharpies. This has like about 23 markers in it, and I'm just looking for like the rainbow colors, so things will be extra pretty. And then basically you need some stuff to stuff your shoe with, so the rubbing alcohol and all of that doesn't bleed through and go on the place where your foot will be, so you don't want that. And then you're just gonna need some white shoes. And again, you can maybe find these anywhere. So yeah, also you can just take some of your old white shoes that you're good with experimenting with, and then you'll be all good. Don't waste anything. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just going to get everything I need. So don't need those. And then I already have the like the shoe stuffer thingy in. So if I need those, I will use them. rubbing alcohol and pour some in the cup. And you might want to just put a little bit more than you think you will need, just in case. I'm going to try and get this. So I will be right back with this thing off of my rubbing alcohol. So yeah. Okay, so you're going to take one of your shoes, and I like to do this. I'm just going to take out my lacings, just because if I want to do a special design on my lacings, I don't want to get anything else on it. So after you take out your lacings, first, just think of something that you know you can do, and if you want to, you can just sketch it out on a piece of paper just to see how it looks, and then just do it on your shoe. So I'm going to do what I did for this, and I'm going to try to do something like that. I'm going to start off with doing the rainbow, and then I'm just going to do some designs. So I'm going to open up and get my orange, green, and I'm not going to be doing the whole rainbow, I'm just going to be doing pink, orange, yellow, green, and blue. I'm going to use this blue since it's a little darker. So what I'm going to do first is just draw a wide line. And here's the thing that you definitely want to avoid doing. If you're doing something like a rainbow, then you don't want to just do like your red or your pink and then put the rubbing alcohol on. You want to make sure that you do the whole rainbow. And I like to do color the whole shoe and then put the rubbing alcohol on. So then I know what all of my designs look like and they're ready to leave. And keep in mind that you don't want to make this like perfect. See how there is some white sort of streaks here? I'm not going to fix those because the rubbing alcohol will bleed it and it will all be pink. Now I'm going to add my orange. And since I have a lot of pink, I'm not going to add as much orange. Your time because you're drawing on a shoe, so it's not really erasable. Just say. And when I'm doing the lines for the rainbow, I don't put the line right where I want it to be because I know that I'm going to sort of come out of the line and then I'm going to have to go again. Some different colors and do some designs. And since I'm not focusing that much on the rainbow colors this time, I'm just going to be adding some pretty colors that I really like. So since my blue is all the way down there, I'm going to be taking one of my lighter blues and doing some spikes at the top of my rainbow. Why I chose blue, first of all, because my blue is all the way down there, so it looks pretty nice. And also because, from my experience, when you're bleeding things, pink and blue look really good together. Because they make my favorite color, purple. And, actually, in one of these shoes, I did dye pink and blue together. And in the middle of it, it made purple, which I really liked. So, if you are a purple lover, then you should try out putting pink and blue together. Now I'm going to take purple. And I'm going to put some hearts. And usually when you think about it, drawing on a shoe seems pretty hard. But when you do it, it's actually not that hard, and it's quite easy. So, let me show you guys. And I really like the pink, the blue, and the purple. They are the three of my favorite colors, but I really like how it looks together. get rubbing alcohol on the words and they still showed up. But for this one, I had Fashion Queen on that and I just remember that it said that, but it doesn't look like it said that, so yeah. And on this one, I wrote a couple letters and this one says falling rainbow in style, and I did not put rubbing alcohol on that, and look how beautiful. Okay guys, I'm done putting Sharpie all over my shoe, so I'm just gonna show you guys what it looks like before I add my rubbing alcohol. So, this is the side that I did not show you guys. So I basically just put some different sides and some dots. This is the back. I just put a heart with blue and red. And then this side, which is now my favorite because I love the hearts and especially how this simple with my lacing. Some Sharpie may get on your table or whatever you're working on, so you might want to have something covering that can get messy. So I'm just going to be using some teal, some light blue, and I'm going to use this really light pink. So I'm going to start off with the teal. I have found out that it helps a lot if you take your thumb and whatever finger you want and just pull on it and then put your Sharpie down, because then it helps it not to go like this while you're trying to put Sharpie on it. And the thing that I love about these shoes is you can wear them without the lacing and it still looks really good. Also, you can wear them with the lacing. And just letting you guys know, it is a bit harder to put the rubbing alcohol on the lacing because the rubbing alcohol can get everywhere and don't put them there. So another reason why you should have like some sort of cloth or something that can get dirty over whatever you're working on. So there is my shoe. So I'm just going to leave that over there and I'm going to start putting rubbing alcohol on my shoe. So to make things easier, I'm going to put my glass and my turn eraser closer so I won't have that long of a way to travel. So the thing is, a lot of people go like this and they go like this and then they're like, oh, that won't put in much, but as you guys can see, it puts in a lot. So I'm just gonna squeeze that out. So I'm just going to squeeze a little bit, and as you guys can see, that is a lot more than I need. So I'm going to tilt it and then just go like this and spread. So I will show you guys what it looks like. Like I said before, it's not going to spread instantly. You need to give it a couple minutes or hours to spread. So patience. And I'm going to need some more. I'm just gonna spread it around, get it everywhere. And you don't wanna put too much. As you guys can now see, my hearts are spreading a little bit. So it does spread pretty fast, but some of it you need to give it some time. So now I'm going to work on this side. But the thing that you definitely have to be patient with. suggest going outside with wet, wet shoes, especially with running. Okay, I know I have shown you guys this side a lot, but it just looks so good. Like, I'm in love with it. Okay, so I'm just going to set this aside right here so it can dry. And now the hard part. I am going to take my shoes. Also, I think that it is better if you let the shoelace dry with the shoe, because that is what I did with these and they dried pretty well. So I think it's best to, when the shoelace is wet, which makes it even harder, in my opinion, I like to let the shoelace dry with the shoe. up to you, but for all of my shoes, you guys can most probably tell that not each side is exactly the same, because not every rainbow is the same, and everything is different. So most of the shoes that I have that I get from the store are the same when they're in each pair. But I thought, again, this is my creation, so I can make the mismatched shoes if I want to. So that is totally up to you guys, but I just like the mismatch sort of thing. So that is how I am doing my shoes. And just letting you guys know, it's really cool. And also, you don't have to just keep on following the exact same patterns you did the last time. Because who knows, you may have some new cool ideas that you want to do for the next shoe that you didn't do for the other shoe. And now, I just thought about doing this. Now, if you have, like, say I have these two pairs and I lose one of those pairs, I can just be like, ta-da! It's all great again. It's all great again. So you can just, that's the glory of using mismatched shoes. But it's just like doing mismatched socks. Like if you lose your other sock, you can be like, who cares? I have this sock and it looks good with that sock. So I have this done right here. And now moving on to my shoelace, which should not take very long. Just letting you guys know about that because I love mismatch. And although I don't have like any mismatch shoes, I thought that it would be cool to do this because what's wrong with mismatch? Because we wear mismatch socks all the time, so let's wear mismatch shoes too. But the thing is, I'm using like some of the same colors, so it's still cool. These actually have bled very fast, so I'm really happy about that. And then these, I have actually tested it out on these,
So now I know for sure, just letting you guys know again, then if you get water, if you get water or you get rain or anything like that on these shoes, it will not ruin them and the marker won't go everywhere, so yes. And these shoes are great for summer, walking on the beach or just going to school or work or anything like that. They are very comfortable and they have lots of loud and designs and they're just ba-bam. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed all of these shoes. So before I leave, you can contact me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And if you like these shoes, then make sure to check out my website, which is www.isabellesheart.com. And soon I'm going to have a Bella Blash boutique, and if you like these shoes, you can purchase them there. Can possibly purchase them there, so yeah. So again, thank you guys for watching, so bye.